Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. And in this video, we're going to talk about the most commonly asked iOS interview question. That is, suppose we have a view controller and we have two labels side by side, horizontally aligned, having some horizontal constraint as well. Now, both of these labels have some other constraint, like having top constraint, having trailing constraint for the right one, having leading constraint for the left one. Now, the interviewer would say that I want one of those labels to have some dynamic height. Now, how would you manage the situation? How would you, put the constraints right so that no conflict occur, and also the functionality that is required, that is the dynamic height, that also plays the part. So this is basically a question related to the content hugging priority and content compression resistance priority of these both labels. But the interviewer would not hint you about these two topics because he just wants you to answer these topics. So let's see how you can answer this question. And without any further ado, let's get started. So guys, as you can see right here, we have these two labels inside our view controller. So we have given two constraints to each one of them. We have given the top constraint and leading constraint for the left one, and trailing constraint for the right label. And now we need to put these labels in the situation that our interviewer is basically asking us to manage. So let's give it a horizontal spacing, then the problem will actually arise. Now let's give it a constant value, say 12. Now you can see that we have some conflict in the constraints. If you go to this left panel, you would see what the problem is. It is saying that increase the horizontal hugging of label from 251 to 252 to keep its intrinsic width before other views. So what is intrinsic width and what is horizontal hugging? Let me tell you that. So let's go one by one. Let's take intrinsic width first. So intrinsic width is basically intrinsic content size of a UI view, which is a basically a property of UI view, which enables the view to take its size according to the content it contains inside it. So in this case of UI label, we have some text inside it, right? So if I write some text inside it, it will take its size according to the text. That is intrinsic content size for you, right? Now let's talk about the content hugging priority. If we click on this label and go to this side inspector right in the right panel, we can see that we have these two priorities called content hugging priority, and the other one is content compression resistance priority. We also have this intrinsic size right here also. Okay, so I have already told you about intrinsic content size. Let's talk about content hugging priority. So if you just hover right here, you would see its definition, which is it sets the priority with which a view resists being made larger than its intrinsic size. As I told you before, intrinsic size is the size that a view takes according to the content it contains inside it. And this priority actually resists this view from taking more size than its intrinsic size. Alright, so if I reduce the value of this property, then this view will take more size than its intrinsic size. And why Xcode or basically auto layout wants us to do that? Because we have these two labels aligned right here next to each other, and right now they both have same priority value. So it is basically a priority conflict that auto layout is not able to understand which label will take more space, which label will not, which label will get compressed when it will have more text inside it, and which will not. So the basic kind of fight is this priority conflict, not anything else. So please don't confuse it with anything else, because when you put UI views aligned to each other, we can have these situations when we have to change the priorities a little bit in comparison to the other view, because auto layout wants us to be clear about how we want our UI to look like. So in this case, if we want this label to take more space than required, or suppose we want this label to take next line and more lines, suppose if it has more text, so then we need to change its priority because both of these labels currently have same priority. So let's change the priority accordingly. Suppose I want this label to take more space, more than its intrinsic size, so I will reduce its content hugging priority right here. I will make it 250. Now you can see that the error has gone. Now you would see that there is no red line over here, there is no conflict in the left panel. If I give some more text to this label, let's give it. So we have currently label written in both these labels. Let's make some difference and write some, you know, dummy text inside it. If I do that, we see that we still have some problem with the constraint. You can again see we have these red lines again, you know, showing up. And if you go to the left panel, it's now saying that decrease the horizontal compression resistance of the first label, the, you know, dummy text written inside it, from 750 to 749 to make it get clipped before other views. So what this basically saying is that if we write some more text inside this first label, we need to make sure that we have given some priorities accordingly, that if it tries to take more space than required in this particular situation when where we have these constraint fixed accordingly, then it get compressed and takes the another line. So to do that, first we need to change its number of line to 0, because we have explicitly told it that you can only take one line. That's because of that it is, you know, kind of truncating right here. So let's make it 0 first. Now you would see that it has, you know, transformed into two lines, but still the constraint conflict remains there. So that basically is about content compression resistance priority. As the name suggests, the content compression resistance priority is the value which makes the view resist from being compressed. So more the value of content compression priority will be, more the view will try to resist itself from compressing. In the current case, we have both the labels having same content compression priority, and that's what the main issue is, because auto layout would not be able to understand which one of the label will compress first when we, you know, try to put it in some situations like this, where we have more text, where we could have more lines, where we have fixed constraints inside it. So let's change one of these labels, content compression resistance priority. So let's just do this for the first label itself. I will make it 749, which would be less than second label's content compression resistance priority. So now the conflict has gone, because we have told the auto layout that, see, we have this label, we want this label to compress first. After that, you can do the stuff right here. So now the auto layout will easily choose it between these two views, which view to compress first and which, you know, next. So we have told it that you can compress this UI label first. So if I write some more text inside the first label, you would see it will not try to compress the second label, and it will compress itself according to the constraint we have put and will go to next lines if required according to the content it has. So you can see that I have given some more content inside this UI label, the first UI label, and it's taking more space vertically, not horizontally, because we have told that you can compress yourself and it would not get compressed because of this. So guys, this content compression resistance priority and content hugging priority are basically used when we have some conflicts between views priority. Suppose we have two views, we have three views, we have multiple views in the same line, suppose in the same line horizontally or maybe vertically, we could have some situations where we have to, you know, make these changes, because if there would be same priority values for each one of those views, auto layout would not be able to understand which view to compress first, which view to expand first, which view need more size and intrinsic size, and which view does not. Once you solve this problem, once you know that I want this view to have more size, I want this view to get compressed first, then you can easily understand this topic. If you still have any doubt, you can write that in the comment section down below, and I will surely reply to that. So see you in the next one. Bye bye. Jai Hind.